He worked with the legends Neil Diamond, Barbara Streisand, the Rolling Stones, Bob Dylan, George Harrison, Carlos Santana. He coddled egocentric pop stars, stared down the guns of Central American dictators and the bravado of Bill Graham, and flawlessly produced an event worthy of a pope. Patrick Stansfield has brought the same level of professionalism, sense of humor, and extraordinary organizational and diplomatic skill to every task he's been hired to do. Even legendary lighting director Chip Monk calls him one, if not the greatest production manager in the history of the industry. Born Patrick Michael Dickey in Cleveland, Ohio in 1943, he would lose his father on a beach in Okinawa in 1945. His mother, Jean Ann, then married James Stansfield, who adopted Patrick. In 1957, the young Stansfield found himself backstage for a series of New York Metropolitan Opera performances in his hometown. Watching from the fly rail, it was this moment when the theatrical spark was lit. By 1963, he had his Actors' Equity card as an assistant stage manager. The last years of the turbulent 60s found him working at the Tyrone Guthrie Theater, which featured Sunday rock shows. In 1971, Stansfield determined the theater was not in his future. Instead, he decided to follow the money, the production money. Stansfield moved to San Francisco and brazenly knocked on the door of promoter Bill Graham, who had recently started FM Productions. There, Stansfield became the founder of the relatively new and chaotic industry of arena touring. He was production manager for Santana, The Stones, and Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. It was during this period Stansfield established his production ethics and perfected his hallmark style, insisting on his own playing for the band, crew, and equipment. His agile mind and ability to anticipate the unexpected enabled him to control the environment under the most trying circumstances. 1975 would be another turning point. It was during this period he began to work for Jerry Weintraub, which brought about one of the most successful and prolific relationships in rock and roll history. Stansfield would partner with Neil Diamond into the new century, producing an unfathomable 1,062 shows. It was with Diamond that he perfected the now commonplace art form known as encapsulating the artist. No effort was too extreme to make the performer comfortable, and thus life on the road under Stansfield could be sustained for a long time. In between Diamond gigs, Weintraub would keep Patrick busy with tours for Bob Dylan and John Denver. In the early 80s, Patrick helped define the mega event with his work on the 82 and 83 US festivals. Then came July 13, 1985, which Stansfield referred to as the day the music industry grew up. He contributed his considerable skills and connections to the Live Aid show at JFK Stadium in Philadelphia. Throughout the 80s and into the 90s, in between Diamond tours, Patrick found himself working on projects with artists such as Michael Jackson, Sting, and tributes to Roy Orbison and Elvis Presley. However, one project held close to Patrick's heart was his involvement with the Marquis of Tavistock in producing shows at the historic Woburn Abbey. He has been the only production supervisor for the Tavistock family, doing such shows as Tina Turner, Dire Straits, Elton John, and of course, Neil Diamond. 1994 found him working with our greatest diva, Barbara Streisand. Barbara is like a 747, Stansfield is fond of saying. She takes a full crew to get off the end of the runway. She is not difficult, Stansfield adamantly denies. She has incredibly high standards, and those who are up to meeting those standards have no problem. Tonight, Stansfield is honored not only for his own high standards, his talent, and his diplomacy, but also for his appreciation of a fine meal, his ebullient storytelling, and his ability to make anyone feel at ease. Stansfield once said of the touring business, "The performance is continuous, 24 hours a day. At specified intervals, we let in the audience." We're all thankful to be a part of that audience.